and welcome to Global Gab. This is the show where we gab with you about things happening, top trending international news. I'm your host, Katerina Kazayas. All right, so first up this week, deadly attacks, Paris-style attacks, this time in the country of Indonesia. That's right, the city of Jakarta was blasted by coordinated bombs and bombings, including one suicide bomber who detonated himself outside of a Starbucks at a busy mall. Wow. So far, two people are dead and 24 people have been reported injured. ISIS is claiming responsibility for this one. Deadly coordinated attacks also in the African country of Cameroon this week. Two women suicide bombers there responsible for killing 10 people. The women are said to be part of the terrorist organization Boko Haram, which operates in that region. And finally, to leave things on a little bit of a lighter note, this one, the Afghanistan Taliban have finally released Canadian captive Collin Rutherford after 5 years. Rutherford had been captured while he was visiting Afghanistan as a tourist. Rutherford is said to have gained his freedom this week by either people paying the ransom, his family paying a ransom, or reports are also telling us that it may have been a prisoner swap between Canada and the Afghan government, although Canada does claim to not officially negotiate with terrorists. What we can tell you for sure is that Rutherford's family is more than thrilled with this early 2016 outcome. Those were the headlines that were trending this week, January 11th, 2016. Now, we know that you know that a lot more happens globally in the news, so do hit us up daily. We gab via our website. It's globalgab.com. That's global-gab.com, where you can go for all of your top trending international news. For now, I'm your host, Katerina Kazayas. This was Global Gab, and yeah, we'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.